Hello, everyone. We are back, and we are going to now get into our data analysis from our experiment. So we've gathered our data. We're ready to roll. So now it's time to actually get to it and start to read in our data set. So you're going to copy essentially all of those files that we looked at previously, actually that we gathered from our thermocouple. And if you take a look at these files list, again, it's always good to just take a quick sneak peek. So let's look at maybe 1 through 30. And let's look at it in table form just to kind of get a sneak peek of what we're going through so we can clean up the data set. So we've got a lot of kind of headers here telling us when the experiment was done. So I want to start to filter this out. So maybe 10. All right, that's not it. Still too much. Because again, I want to see, look at time versus temperature here and temperature in Celsius. Later, we could probably convert that to Kelvin. And then let's go ahead. There we go. 23 is a nice one. 22, I would still have essentially this little header. So let's get rid of that. So I'm going to take from each of those data sets, 23 all the way to the end of my list. And here's our first one. And if we look at this data file, it is pure lauric acid. So when you look at these curves, you can see it's pretty straight. I mean, again, this is fairly linear. And then we see the discrepancy, and then it's still kind of very linear here. So you have like a short arrest, but it's basically, I see one slope effectively here. So a pure material, we should expect to kind of see this type of behavior where it's a single change of slope and then we're good to go. So we can identify that liquidus or that invariant point. So I'm going to just right click and then let me do this again. Right click, get coordinates, and I'm going to click right here approximately. And then I'm going to control C and I am going to paste this in here. And I don't care about the x-axis value, I just need the temperature. So at zero composition, we don't have a solidus, but we do have a liquidus. Because again, the liquidus on our phase diagram is when we go from liquid to solid. Now, fantastic. And you can see, let's take a peek ahead, just look at the end of the list. You see something kind of very similar here. Again, you know, like we kind of talked about in the course, it's like not idealized. You see a longer arrest period here, but you kind of get the picture, hopefully, of what we're looking at. And also we cut this off as well. So, but anyways, for the pure materials. And then you'll have a surprise essentially for your invariant point. But here it's very, so for our third data set, which corresponds to our composition, again, you have 10 and then 20% stearic. So this was 0% stearic. So we're increasing essentially stearic concentration. You see here, we have this period here, and now we have a clear change in slope for the freezing region here, and then that change to solid. So we're gonna have to pick out, so we're cooling rate constant, and then you see kind of this change in slope right there. So I always like to follow along, and then you can just eyeball, you can kind of click here. So there's gonna be some discrepancies based on the values you select. So I'm gonna click here, and then I'm gonna paste in, and I'm gonna select all two. So these are my kind of 2 points. So the higher temperature is always the liquidus. Now you may be asking, Professor Steinmel, well, how do you actually, like, is there a better numeric way to do this? You can fit and try to do instantaneous fits and see where the slope changes, but these curves are kind of a little bit messy and open to interpretation. So in your, when you create your poster, you may want to dedicate a section in there to kind of, how did you analyze these things, right? How did you break down? How did you select? Show some examples, preferably clean examples like this one. And then that will answer essentially those questions. So for 20 composition, we have a solidus, the lower temperature, and a liquidus here. So we can do this. And now what I'm going to do, and again, you would do this for every plot here. So it's a lot of work, but I believe in you and you can do it. And so what you'll do now, once you kind of get all the data points for all the compositions, and you have these basically files that are lined up, you want to create basically an X and Y. So I'm going to plot my, you know, so I could say plot liquid, which is going to be, I'm going to transpose on my X-axis, I want comp, composition. And then on my y-axis, I want my liquid points. And I can do also plot my solid. And then that's going to be the same thing. Transpose on my x-axis, I need composition. On my y-axis, I want my solids. And we can see here. So I can go ahead and plot those things. So I want to do my plot my our P liquid, P solid. I want for my, where's my directive? I'm going to have a list of here. Blue is the first one, which is liquid, which is great. And then solidus, I want that as my red. And then we need to do point size. Point size. And we can get this a little bit even, so we can kind of look at this here. See, so we need to, let's increase these a bit. And this looks a little bit nasty now, but we can do, for example, and it may be good. Thinking of, you may actually, let's put this in Kelvin. Let's see if this works. Okay, it still works, even though the NA is there. You may think about putting this in Kelvin, just because that's our standard SI definition. Let's take care of these things. Fantastic. Excellent. Actually, hang on a second. Yeah, I guess we can take a look at that really quickly, actually. Let's, excuse me for a second. I'm going to just, let's take this. I'm trying to look at, I think I clicked a little bit. Starting to really see that delineation maybe here and here. So again, I'm just trying to see, getting a better idea of where that slope is. So I'm just going to pull this out here. I'm gonna do this here. Again, it's not a huge deal. There's going to be some amount of air in here. So we're going to do, that was from this. Let's put this one here. Let's put this one. This one's pretty accurate, so it's very similar. Again, you're kind of seeing, again, you may want to kind of go back and look through kind of this data set. So let's do plot range instead of all. Let's go from 0 to 100, and then let's go from, like, let's do 270, not 270, let's do 280 to 360. X and Y terms. So let's go ahead and look out here. And you can kind of see that's a little bit too big. Let's do 0.01. And let's go ahead right here. And you can see it's a little bit, so we need to actually go back a little bit. So instead of 0, we can go minus 10. And again, you can adjust kind of all these, probably not minus 10, because then it'll show up there are two obvious. Here, we may need to increase our point size a little bit now. Let's see how these all look. It's too big. How about this? And again, you can change these with plot markers and do other cool things. But so we're seeing essentially here your liquidus, and then your solidus will effectively be over here. So you're going to make essentially this phase diagram, and you will plot this for all the different compositions. You will identify any invariants, any kind of distinguishing features. We may zoom in a little bit here just so we can see some cool features. So you can kind of see. So we should always kind of start off at the edges, highest melting point, and they should be lower liquidus, and then same thing over here. But we'll see that in those features. So do this for all the different compositions. If you have questions, again, a lot of this is open somewhat to interpretation. Given that that is the case, so we can kind of make some adjustments as we move along here, or to our analysis effectively here, because you can see a little bit of kind of an arrest here. Yours may look a little bit different from your partners or other teams, but again, no worries and good luck. So we'll also be sharing, actually, one last thing we have to look at, but we'll also be uploading essentially some videos of, or actually some data files of thermal stability. So how well these plots, as you heat and cool them, how well they retrace. And so you'll probably are going to include those in your analysis as well. So, but those will just be import and be ready to go. So we'll see you then. Thanks. Bye.